So I'm Irina Earnshaw. I'm a medical student from Scotland. I'm here at UCSF as a summer intern working with Graham Johnson. I'm learning a bit more about medical illustration and just visualizing sort of processes in the cell and everything. Well, because there's so much still to discover in neuroscience, I think that medical illustration can play a really important role in the future, especially with imaging, because there is only so much that you can really see in the brain compared to the circuits that are actually going on. So I think sort of finding new ways of showing people what's going on in their brains, especially patients before they have surgery or things, to help them understand why they're having the problems that they're having, I think that could be really great. And just helping us to understand more about how the brain actually works. Well, I come from a family of scientists, so I was never pushed into science, but I think that it was a lot more present for me than it is for most people. And it was, you know, sitting around when I was like 5 years old around the dinner table, and my parents would be talking about proteins and stuff that I had no idea what they were talking about, but I knew it was really interesting. And then, so it was never a question for me. I knew I was going to go into science. I'd always been interested in medical illustration, but I sort of naively thought that it didn't really exist as a profession anymore. And I went to university to study medicine, and then I realized that my love of art was getting really neglected. Being able to finally do art in a sort of career context is really nice for me. It's pretty different every day, I think, yeah, which is quite fun. So you can spend a couple of days not necessarily not doing much, but you can be doing a lot of the same thing, and then all of a sudden you have one day where you just do loads of different stuff and you get everything done in one day, and it's kind of funny because everything comes together, and then that's really fun. Oh, it's collaborative, definitely. And especially because it's such a small lab, it's quite nice because it means, and because I'm definitely still learning, and Megan and Graham know so much, it's great for me to just sort of be able to lean over and be like, hey Megan, this isn't working like it should be, and she can say, oh right, okay, well, you know, I've got this going on, and she can show me how to figure it out and things. So it's very collaborative.
How the cycling, but we do know how to use the cycling, so then we can do that.
When you start a project, you start it by sort of drawing some samples and sort of getting how you imagine the layout of everything is going to look, and then move on to computer, and you're spending all your time sort of, picking out colors and things. So. The fact that you're discovering new things, I think, is pretty great. If you're just doing kind of a 9-to-5 job working, I don't know, say in a bank or something, you're making a lot of money, but you're not really advancing much. I think that's what's great about science. And the fact that there's always something new to learn as well, I like that. The fact that you can be, you know, in your 60s and still working, you're still finding out new things that you didn't know before. And, you know, not necessarily stuff that everybody didn't know before, just stuff that you didn't find out about, and you read it in a textbook or something. I think that's pretty cool. Generally, you need to be a good people person, I think. I'm not sure what else. Oh, curiosity, I guess. That's probably one of the main things. If you're passionate about something and you're really curious and you really want to find out more, then that's probably the main thing.